Hey everybody, it's the Ioniq guy here. Today's video is an exciting one because it's been a few months since we got an update to the car, but today we finally got one. It's April 28th, 2022, and this update contains some cool stuff, my favorite being full screen Android Auto. But there's a few other things thrown in there, some tweaks to the menus and how the system operates. So in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to download and install the updating software for your Mac, and then how to create a thumb drive that you can then install the update in your car with. Unfortunately, this update does not include the over-the-air update that we've been waiting for, and it also doesn't include battery preconditioning, which is a shame, but I'll take any update I can get at this point. And then after that, I'm going to show you all the new changes in the software, and I'm going to show you the differences compared to how they were prior to this update. But anyway, there's a lot to go over in this video, so let's get started. So go to update.hyundai.com and click on Navigation Update or Download, and that'll get you to the section to download for Mac or PC. Open up the file that downloads. Select United States, Hyundai, and whichever language you speak. Accept the terms and conditions, hit Next. Once it's installed, hit Complete. Now you're going to log in with your Hyundai account. Click OK. Now here you can pick what car you have, in our case the 2022 Ioniq 5. Select the hard drive where you want it to download the file. Then you're going to click Next. And the file should begin downloading. Now this is going to take a little bit. Then insert your USB drive into the computer, and you're going to format the card and transfer the files from your hard drive to the thumb drive. Now it gives you this message confirming that you're using a thumb drive. If it's over 32 gigabytes, it thinks it might be another hard drive. So after you continue, it'll start copying the files to your thumb drive. And once they're all copied, you can eject it and quit the software. So once you get in the car, you're going to take your USB drive, plug that into the front USB port. You have to use this port. So we're going to put the car in accessory mode by pressing the button twice. And immediately after starting, you'll see it says start the audio system update. And it gives you the build number for this update. And so I'm just going to hit update now. Let's see what it says here for details. Route options added. Let's start the update. Preparing system update. So I'm going to start a timer just to see how long this actually takes. Because the last time I did an update, it took far longer than it said it was going to. So we'll see how this does. So if we go to Setup, General, here we see that it was updated today, and here's the new software version. So for me, the biggest thing here is having full screen Android Auto. So to enable that, I'm going to go to Device Connections, scroll down here to Phone Projection Settings, and I'm going to turn off Use Split Screen on Android Auto. We got full screen Android Auto, and wow, it looks good. It looks a lot sharper than it used to. So for those of you who currently use Apple CarPlay, you now have the option of using split screen. So if you go to Setup, Device Connections, Phone Projection Settings, Apple CarPlay, Use Split Screen on Apple CarPlay screen. So if you have that checked, you'll be able to do split screen, and I'll show you that right now. So here's Apple CarPlay in split screen. If you hide it, it just says Apple CarPlay, my iPhone. So yeah. That's a nice new feature. Another change we should see is an update to the driver assistance settings. So if we go to Settings, Vehicle, driver assistance. Now we get a pictogram type display where it has all of the settings you might want to adjust. So this is a little more user friendly than just a big long list. Okay, but you can switch to the old view via this button here. So if you prefer that screen, you can use that. So another new thing on the EV front, go to the menu up here, energy information, electricity usage. And this is kind of a new look to this screen. Another thing a lot of people have been asking for is to be able to have the light and dark theme tied to time of day and whether it's after dark or before dark. So if you go to setup, screen theme slash layout, here we have our themes. Okay, and here's the automatic. Displays the white theme in daylight conditions and the black theme in nighttime conditions. So that's a really welcome feature because I was using scheduled time, and once we entered daylight savings time, it messed up my settings. So this is nice to see. I'm glad Hyundai listened on this one. So another change is to the climate control screen. And I'll show you what it used to look like and what it does look like now. So you can see they moved driver only from this position over to here, which makes more sense because it should be closer to the driver than to the passenger. And then the sync button and the heat button, these got moved around a little bit. But besides that, it's pretty much the same other than the driver only button being moved to the left-hand side. So another change in this update is to the radio screen. You can see we no longer have the fake tubes here anymore. It's a lot more modern looking. So something else that was updated was the voice assistant screen and how it appears on the center display. So now it pops in from the right hand side with this cool little animation, and it reads out what you're saying right on the screen. So that's neat. So if you are in the map screen and you press the button for the voice assistant, it no longer covers the map. It pops in with its own little screen and the map stays whole. Something else I'm noticing with this update that I haven't seen anywhere else is I think you have more options with the custom buttons. So on the steering wheel, I used to have the custom button go to the home screen. But I would have preferred it to go to the EV screen and have the star button in the center console go to the home screen. And now here I can pick the EV screen. So I'm happy to see that. And I'm not 100% sure, but there might be a few more options in here for the center console custom button. Since I have the SEL trim, there's a few things in this update that don't apply to my car, so I can't show you them. One would be that somebody on the Facebook group said that the 360-degree camera stitching is a lot better and looks more true to life. So I think that's going to do it for this video. I'm going to keep making more videos on all future updates to just show you guys all the new features that we get. And as always, thanks for watching. Hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed the video. Hit subscribe if you haven't already, because there's going to be a lot more videos coming out in the future. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.